My mother's maiden name was McLean, right? And this is McLean's property from back in the 1800s, where the original owners of this particular property here. My mother, she was born in the probably 1920s, but I've been here all my life, you know. Like if you had bought land, you know, 15, 20 years ago, you'd be triple your investment, you know. We've been lucky for the last 3 or 4 years, the price of livestock has gone up as well. In all my lifetime, I've never seen cattle as dear as what they are now. Yeah, fuel and electricity has gone up. The power companies, they can just put the price up whenever they feel like it. They've got a monopoly on energy, and our quarterly power bill was increasing, you know, every quarter. Some quarter was up nearly $1,000, you know. I just had to make a decision and go solar.
When Trevor gave us a ring, I could tell he was now keen to get solar. He told me he's been looking for a while and said, surely someone's got to come out and have a look.
I spoke to a guy who had had dealings with Brad before. He said, yeah, go and see Brad. He's a good guy to deal with. So I went and saw him, and he came out and we had a bit of a talk about it. I told him what I wanted. He said, yeah. Gave me a quote, and I said, right, we'll go with that.
Upon arriving and meeting Trevor, straight away we found that the existing structures that he had, roofs to mount solar to, just weren't ideal. And it was Trevor actually who mentioned to me, what about these solar farms that have just opened up here? What about these ground mount solutions? You know, can I do one of them? I've got lots of land here. And straight away, you know, I thought, well, if you're keen, then let's explore a solution.
I thought about the lost production of these two little paddocks, because I used to run, you know, a few stock here, a few sheep, a few horses or whatever. But I think these will produce more dollars than what the paddock will with running stock in it.
So the choice of mounting gear for this ground mount installation, it's the Solar Terrace 2A by PV Easy Rack, which is backed by Clenergy. As soon as I contacted the engineers and tech support at Clenergy, it made it all too easy. They asked me what size panel, what area we're in, and straight away they came back with a design, and it was just easy to follow the spacings they had to be apart, how deep, the type of concrete, and you are now working within their engineered certificates, and you know you've done it right. Once the posts were all in and installed, within the first day, all the Clenergy Solar Terrace 2 frames, everything was all up. Came back second day, panels, inverter, connection, underground, one more day. All said and done, a system like this, you know, 4 days you can have this completed, connected and commissioned and working. Our choice of inverter for this project was the Fronius Primo 5 kW single phase model. Being two phase, we put one inverter on each phase to get that full 10 kW export out to the grid.
About 2.7 each, 2.5, 2.4, and there's no sun.
Fronius is our number one favourite and first choice of inverter. Got a Fronius on my house, and the reason for that is they're just like Trevor's got the Land Cruiser 70 series over there. I call this the Land Cruiser 70 series of inverter. It just goes and goes and goes. And that is what you want to offer to any of your customers, is that reliability.
You know, the panels are working, don't you? If you see what the kilowatt rate is.
We went with the Jinko N-Type 370 watt panel. The reason for that is that Jinko, we've been installing their panel for many years, thousands of installations, always found the product to be fantastic. And hey, I've got them on my roof. So, and the reason for that is great panel at a great cost. N-Type is very high purity, high quality, high efficiency type of cell. So they also back that with that longer warranty because of this, of 20 year product, 30 year performance. So all these reasons stack up as to being the best choice for Trevor.
I could have put them on my roof, but for the ease of operation, ease of maintenance, on ground's the way to go.
Another benefit being you can easily install the systems and panels, get all your cable clips and everything managed properly, and you don't have that risk of an MC4 plug sitting on the tin roof and potentially getting that water ingress. So that's another unique opportunity. And we can also, you know, for maintenance reasons, Trevor, as the owner, can see that there's no issues under the panels. These are all just benefits that you just cannot get with a roof mount system.
The setup we have now, where our hot water service runs straight off the solar. So when the sun shines, I'll get cheap hot water.
My message out there for the families is invest in our renewable future. And the way you do that, like Trevor here has done, install solar, heat pump, hot water, whatever it is, buy a hybrid car. Invest in those renewables to save the planet.
Any famous people through the generations come by this property?
Well, I said before, my great grandfather entertained Ned Kelly at one stage when he was riding through the district, you know, mm-hmm. bush ranger. Mm-hmm. He didn't worry the local farmers. Mm-hmm. They got on well with him, all the, you know, local people. It was only the police that had a bit of a set against him.